Hello learners, Namaste. This is Dr. Ramak Dias from Government Polytechnic Jalgaon welcoming you to this module on active learning versus passive learning. In this module, the learners will be able to define passive and active learning, improve retention percentage in students through active learning strategies, implement deeper learning strategies in the teaching for higher learning outcomes, differentiate between active and passive learning. Dear teachers, now let us consider various scenarios which we use for teaching to our students to understand what is passive and what is active learning. Take this scenario one of hearing lectures. Students acquire knowledge by hearing lectures. And students hear till they are attentive. Here, the activity is to hear. Scenario two, reading books. Students acquire knowledge by reading books, journals, and online resources. They read books before or after lectures or during exams. Here, the activity is to read. Scenario 3. Students acquire knowledge by seeing charts, pictures, or through visualization of data and graphics used in presentations. Here, the activity is to see. Scenario 4. Students acquire knowledge by watching videos where seeing and hearing are the two actions that goes on simultaneously. So here the activity is see and hear. Scenario 5. Students acquire knowledge by seeing and hearing the demonstrations which are given by teachers. Here also the activity is see and hear. So all the above scenarios shows us that the students learn by hearing, reading, seeing, or they can use see and hear as the activity. Here, these methods are called as passive learning methods because students are not taking any active efforts for learning. Therefore, it is teacher-centered and student involvement is minimal. Thus, passive learning is acquisition of knowledge by learners without any efforts done by them. Now, it's a time to reflect and think. Consider this question. Which other teaching methods do you use in your classroom for your students? Apart from what we have seen above. Now, pause the video, think and record your answers in the notebook. Once you are done, then play the video. Yes. We will now consider other scenarios which you have written as answers in your notebooks. Scenario 6. Students acquire knowledge by discussing within the groups. They say and write in the process. Scenario 7. Students acquire knowledge through presentations on certain topics allotted to them in groups or in individual presentations. Here also, the students write and say during their presentations. Scenario 8, role plays, street plays, enactments. Students learn through the act of saying and doing. Scenario 9. Students acquire knowledge by doing case studies or simulations. They are involved in the act of say and do. Scenario 10. Here, the students acquire knowledge by doing the experiments in the laboratory or as field work. They are involved here in the act of write, say, and do. If you come across all these activities of group discussions to practicals, you will see that students are involved either in saying, writing, or doing. Therefore, in active learning, the students are learning through activities. Their involvement is maximal. Therefore, active learning is the process by which students learn after getting involved into the activity. Having seen the difference in the active and passive learning, the more basic question comes, what is learning? You will agree with me that learning is the change in knowledge brought about by suitable pedagogy. Now, how to measure this change? We can measure it by how much information has been retained. Therefore, Edgar Dell came up with pyramid of learning, which is presented here. The lecture we as teachers give can have average retention rate of only 5%, and we spend our major time in giving the lectures. So if you come to reading, it is 10% retention. Audio visual, it is 20%. Demonstration, it is 30%. So all these traditional ways of teaching or passive learning will have maximum retention of 30%. But if you move from passive teaching to active teaching learning process, if you go to discussion, it is 50% of average retention. If you practice by doing, as in practicals or case studies or simulations, you will get the average retention of 75%. And if you go or apply immediately whatever you have learned or you teach to your peers, then you get the maximum retention of 90%. So, the change in knowledge here will be highest, or the retention will be highest through active learning strategies. Now, we will go towards the another concept, that how we can improve this retention of information that can be used either for defining, applying, analyzing, evaluating, or creating something new. So, can we use the retained information to have better outcomes? Those can be taken as learning outcomes. So, Benjamin Bloom came up with Bloom's taxonomy. And you have already studied this Bloom's taxonomy from Dr. K.U. Bansur, sir. We will see how this learning outcome can be made better using active learning strategies. So for that, we will compare the pyramid of learning and Bloom's taxonomy. Learning pyramid, from passive to active, we are getting more retention. In the Bloom's taxonomy, you can see that we can achieve more from remembering to creating. If you consider the learning outcomes, here, if you see passive learning, one can achieve remembering, understanding, and applying, which can also be called as lower order thinking skills. The students will be able to define, describe, list, explain, demonstrate, or apply through passive teaching learning process. But if you come to the active learning strategies, you can have higher order thinking skills of analyzing, evaluating, and creating. The students will be able to analyze, create, design. So we can achieve higher order outcomes if we use the active learning strategies of discussion, practice by doing, and teaching others. So it is very clear that from active learning strategies, we can achieve higher retention as well as higher learning outcomes. Now, let us differentiate active and passive learning. We can see students are actively engaged, and therefore it is called as student-centered learning in case of active learning. Here in passive learning, students are not engaged, and therefore it is called as teacher-centered learning. When to use active learning? This can be used to enhance the learning, but passive learning can be used when new material is to be presented to the students. Now, as far as retention is concerned, retention is very high in active learning, but that retention will be low in passive learning. We can achieve better outcomes, learning outcomes, or we can say higher order thinking skills are achieved through active learning, and lower order thinking skills are there, or they can be achieved by passive learning. Here in active learning, students take their own responsibility of learning, while teachers are responsible for students' learning in passive learning. Here, the role of a teacher is changed to facilitator. But here, the teacher has to teach, and therefore the commanding role is there in passive learning. Now, with this, we can conclude that we have to shift our focus from teacher-centered passive learning to student-centered active learning, which ensures high retention and better learning outcomes. Thank you.